Hi, good evening everyone. Dr. Gagandeep for this side from Weaving Dreams. Huge amount of time and energy goes into making videos and then uploading them on YouTube. With millions of YouTubers, it's actually equally tough to get your videos discovered. Much of search and getting the videos above in the search depends upon the YouTube description. So friends, today we will be understanding the various points that we have to keep in mind while giving a YouTube description, so that if we give that in a correct manner, that can boost the SEO, the subscription, the view counts and the watch time. Giving a correct description for our YouTube video can also help our videos to rank in the YouTube's suggested search function. This is what all I have learned during all these months when I have been putting the description for my various YouTube videos. So I would like to share all these points with you today. The first thing that we have to keep in mind is to use the specific keywords. Always try to use one or two keywords that very accurately describe your content to maximize the search traffic to your video. This is what I have learned. I would also like you to see the previous two videos that I have made, how I could actually attain 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours in just a matter of few months. I'll just be sharing the link here. Also, go and check the video that I have made on how to give the appropriate title. And now after the appropriate title, we have to make use of specific keywords for the description. Always remember to include these words, these specific 1 to 2 keywords in your video's description, so that the chances of ranking of your video in potential viewers' search results increases. I'm telling this because YouTube's algorithm places a lot of importance on the keywords in your about page. So therefore, we should definitely use them very wisely. You may also use the tools like Google Ads to get the help for this. What we can do is we can simply type in the words that best describe what your channel or your video is all about, and the Google will suggest the closest related words just in case you don't have certain words in your mind. Second point, repeat your keywords. You know what happens? Whenever we are repeating the keywords in the description, that lets the YouTube also know about a particular term which is very relevant to your video or your channel. So use your keywords 2 to 3 times for the best results. Yes, do not overdo them. Do not make use of repetitively all these keywords. 1, 2, 3, 4 times is more than sufficient. Third point, find the complementary keywords. Include related keywords in your description. Related is complementary. Now this would provide the viewers with extra information about your content. It will also help you rank for those terms in Google and YouTube searches. Now, for example, when you're posting a video on debates, you may add keywords as students. If you've had a discussion with the students, you can put the word students, group discussions, technology, online education, thoughts, perspectives, etc. Just check the YouTube. We have organized certain new talks live on my YouTube channel. Just go and check the kind of description that I have tried to make there, that I've tried to write there, so that my video comes up on the search. And yes, we've got over 1,000 of views on those videos. Very important point, fourth point, never misrepresent your videos. Misrepresent means that you should always give in the description whatever you are actually showing in your video. Otherwise, what will happen, the viewers will simply stop watching them. This will damage your search rankings as well as your reputation also. There's one word that I earlier also used while making the video on what kind of titles we should choose. I'm sharing the link here. I'm also going to share the link in the description. Avoid clickbait titles and irrelevant keywords. You know what happens? They might help you rank at first, but YouTube's search algorithm will catch sooner or later. And what will happen, the your viewers will stop watching your videos also, because they, what they'll realize that you are showing something else, you're writing something else in the description, and you are showing something else. Fine. So fifth point, which is most important, write the description in a very natural manner. Natural manner is something like we are talking to someone. For example, now I'm talking to someone. Because you should know your audience. Use the language that your viewers will understand. It can be English, it can be Hindi, it can be any other language, because that depends upon your target audience. You know the best what kind of language your audience understands and that can relate to. Incorporate the keywords in a natural way, not as a list. So for example, you can always write like, this video would be sharing, for example, I would be writing here that this video would be sharing certain tips or points that will help you in writing description. That means this is something that I'm talking to you. Write in a natural manner. Sixth point, use HTTP. Why? Because your video description is one of the few places YouTube lets you link out. Fine, use it. Remember to add HTTP to all the URLs to make them clickable. I'm also going to use this in the description. You can always check out. Seventh point, add a few hashtags. You know what hashtags are? They are the simple way to help the viewers find your content as long as you use them wisely. At the same time, always keep in mind that stick to 15 hashtags or less, not more than that, or YouTube will ignore them just altogether. As always, make sure that they are relevant to your video. Relevant, that means whatever you are showing in your video, don't ever put misleading hashtags, because what that will do, again, they will get frustrated and they will never come back to your channel. So the hashtags that you are using should be very relevant. You should use them, but not more than 15, and they should be totally relevant. Eighth point, add links and metadata below the fold. If a viewer does decide to show more chances, they love your stuff. You always should use this opportunity to promote your brand. You can always add a brief channel description also while writing the description of a particular video. You can also mention your social media handles and relevant product links. You can also include metadata here to boost your SEO. Next point, don't forget to add the links as I just mentioned. In simple words, mention your useful links. So what will happen? The audience will keep engaging with your other social profiles or websites also. You can add any links here, but mention those properly without any broken links. So if you just ask that what kind of links you can add, they can be the social profile links, they can be the affiliate links. Social profile links may include LinkedIn or Instagram or Facebook, or they can be next related to the next related video links. For example, the other videos that you have already done, you can put their links also. Because when you add these kinds of links, it engages more with the audience, with your channel, and it also brings your views. It brings you more views. And in case you are using any affiliate link, then mention, don't forget to mention the disclaimer properly. You always have to mention the disclaimer. For example, you're using any affiliate link, you have to mention that it's a disclaimer from your side. Fine. So these are the various things that I had to tell you today, what kind of words or sentences you have to use while writing the description for your video. These points are really very important, because if you write them properly, as I just mentioned, that can boost your SEO, that can increase your subscriptions, that can increase your view counts, and obviously your watch time also. And this is what many of the YouTubers are actually doing. And above all, what can happen if you use the description in a proper manner, that can help your videos rank in the YouTube's suggested search function. So I hope you have learned something from the things that I shared with you today. And for the other things, I would keep on sharing how to make thumbnails and all. That means the various other things that increase the search of your particular YouTube video, I would be sharing them in the next videos. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel so that you get the updates on what all new videos that we are coming up with. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.
Don't forget to hit the like button.